Hey everyone, welcome to the channel. Well, there are a ton of custom ROMs in this ever-growing Android community, as we all are in search for more and more features to make the most of our smartphone experience. So one such ROM is evolutionx. Well, I did a review on it a few months ago, and after trying out literally a ton of ROMs, I wanted to give this a second chance, since it was so full of features. So in this video, let's revisit the evolutionx ROM and let's find out if it is better than our stock firmware. So before we start, if you wish to stay notified about the latest videos, do click on that subscribe button and press the bell icon next to it. So I will go through overall features, battery life, and lastly the gaming performance on this ROM. So stay tuned till the end to know all about it. Well, as you can see, the ROM itself looks nice and clean, with pixel-like stock UI. But this is where the similarities end, because it contains a ton of customizations that you will not find on any Android ROM. Now in themes, you have a variety of options to choose from, even for dark mode. So this is something new. And you can customize fonts, icon shapes, choose the icons you want in status bar, amongst other standard options. In status bar settings, you can control the icons, choose battery percentage, customize the clock, and whatnot. Plus you do have the edge lighting feature as well, which makes it really handy for those devices that do not have a physical LED for notifications. And it really makes all the difference. And in the quick settings panel, you get the ability to modify every little thing possible. You can toggle between quick pull down settings, add a brightness slider, and even choose the icons to take the customization game to a whole new level. Plus you get the ability to take long screenshots, and the three finger screenshot option from OxygenOS is also there, with the option to choose the type of screenshot you want, full or partial. You can even hide this ugly back icon for a seamless stock Android experience. And for those of you who love gaming, well, there is a dedicated gaming mode as well. And you can turn off all the notifications, pop-ups, and disable automatic brightness, which comes in really handy. And in my time with it, games like PUBG run just fine on extreme settings, with no hiccups or heating issues whatsoever. Plus the battery drain was also minimum. Plus you have this neat charging animation that looks great. And I almost forgot, this one also has ambient display and always on display. And you can customize it by choosing the amount of brightness you want. So these are some of the add-ons in this ROM. But wait, it doesn't end here. You have some of the best features from OxygenOS, like DC dimming, touchscreen gestures, along with the alert slider customization, to name amongst a few. Speaking about features from OxygenOS, well, this one does have OxygenOS camera and gallery app for Oneplus devices, for those of you who just cannot be at the loss of OxygenOS. Plus the latest Gcam is also baked right into the system. But is really everything great with this ROM? Well, no. It has its fair share of issues, like the settings you just saw. Well, these are isolated and scattered here and there, and it would have been great if they were sorted with all the settings. Plus the off-screen gestures stopped working in the recent version, but they used to work in past as far as I remember. And also, some of the customization just don't work in first attempt. But well, all of this is fixable, and I hope developers of this ROM will fix it with OTAs. And nothing in this is enough to stop someone from using it as a daily driver. Plus voice over Wi-Fi works well, just in case you were wondering. So the overall standby drain on this ROM was bare minimum, though I have my concerns with the overall battery backup, but I really like how it performs. But the screen on time it provides can be improved a bit. So I got around 5 hours and 30 minutes on an average on a single charge, which is good enough for standard usage. So yeah, that was it. This is how I feel about evolutionx after months of switching over from one custom ROM to another. So if you have any questions, do let me know in the comments down below. And do like this video if it helps you out. And I'll see you guys in the next one.